ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। Reading from the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 7, Chapter 1. The Supreme Lord is equal to everyone. Text number 25. It is a prose, so we'll try to read. Yan nibhadu bhimano yam tad bhadhat praninam badha. Okay, we'll try it again. Yan nibhado bhimano yam tad bhadhat praninam badha. There's an echo. Tata nayasya kaivalyad abhimanu kilatmana. Tata nayasya kaivalyad abhimanu kilatmana. Parashya dama kartur hi himsa kinasya kalpyate. Parashya dama kartur hi himsa kinasya kalpyate. Word for word meaning, yat, in which, nibadha, bound, abhimanaha, false conception, ayam, this, tat, of that, body, badat, from the annihilation, praninam, of the living beings, buddha, annihilation. Tata, similarly, na, not. Yashya, of whom? Kaivalyat, because of being absolute, one without a second. Abhimanaha, false conception. Akila atmana, of the super soul, of all living entities. Parashya, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Dhammakartuhu, the Supreme Controller. He, certainly, himsa, harm. Kena, how? Asya, his. Kalpyate, is performed. Translation and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Because of the bodily conception of life, the conditioned soul thinks that when the body is annihilated, the living being is annihilated. Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is the Supreme Controller, the super soul of all living entities. Because he has no material body, he has no false conception of I and mine. It is therefore incorrect to think that he feels pleasure or pain when blasphemed or offered prayers. This is impossible for him. Thus, He has no enemy and no friend. When he chastises the demons, it is for their good. And when he accepts the prayers of the devotees, it is for their good. He is affected neither by prayers nor by blasphemy. Purport. Because of being covered by material bodies, the conditioned souls, including even greatly learned scholars and falsely educated professors, all think that as soon as the body is finished, everything is finished. This is due to their bodily conception of life. Krishna has no such bodily conception, nor is his body different from his self. Therefore, since Krishna has no material conception of life, how can he be affected by material prayers and accusations? Krishna's body is described herewith as Kaivalya, none different from himself. Since everyone has a material bodily conception of life, if Krishna had such a conception, what would be the difference between Krishna and the conditioned soul? Krishna's instructions in Bhagavad Gita are accepted as final because he does not possess a material body. As soon as one has a material body, he has four deficiencies. But since Krishna does not possess a material body, he has no deficiencies. He is always spiritually conscious and blissful. Isvara Parama Krishna Sachit Ananda Vigraha. His form is eternal, blissful knowledge. Sachit Ananda Vigraha, Ananda Chinmaya Rasa, and Kaivalya are the same. Krishna can expand himself as Paramatma in the core of everyone's heart. In Bhagavad Gita, chapter 13, text 3, this is confirmed. Kshetragyam chapi mang vidhi sarva kshetresu bharata. The Lord is the Paramatma, the Atma or Super Self of all individual souls. Therefore, it must naturally be concluded that he has no defective bodily conceptions, although situated in everyone's body. He has no bodily conception of life. He is always free from such conceptions, and thus, he cannot be affected by anything in relation to the material body of the jiva. I'll repeat that one. He is always free from such conceptions, and thus he cannot be affected by anything in relation to the material body of the jiva. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 16, text 19, Tan aham vishita kruran samsrasiv samsaresu naradamam kshipami ajasram asubam asurisu eva yunishu. Those who are envious and mischievous, who are the lowest among men, are cast by me into the ocean of material existence, into various demoniac species of life. Whenever the Lord punishes persons like demons, however, such punishment is meant for the good of the conditioned soul. The conditioned soul, being envious of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, may accuse him, saying, Krishna is bad, Krishna is a thief, and so on. But Krishna, being kind to all living entities, does not consider such accusations. Instead, he takes account of the conditioned soul's chanting of Krishna, Krishna, so many times. He sometimes punishes such demons for one life by putting them in a lower species. But then, when they have stopped accusing him, they are liberated in the next life because of chanting Krishna's name constantly. Blaspheming the Supreme Lord or his devotee is not at all good for the conditioned soul. But Krishna, being very kind, punishes the conditioned soul in one life for such sinful activities and then takes him back home, back to Godhead. The vivid example for this is Brit Asura, for who was formerly Chitraketu Maharaj, a great devotee. Because he derided Lord Shiva, the foremost of all devotees, he had to accept the body of a demon called Britra, but then he was taken back to Godhead. Thus, when Krishna punishes a demon or conditioned soul, he stops the soul's habit of blaspheming him, and when the soul becomes completely pure, the Lord takes him back to Godhead. Thus end the Bhaktivedanta purport and the seventh canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 1, text 25. Srila Prabhupada ki.
Om jnana timirandasya gyanan gyana salakaya chaksurun militam jena tasmai shri gurave namaha shri chaitanya manovistam stapitam yena bhutale swayam rupa kadamayam dadati swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Juta Padakamalang Shri Gurung Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatan Sahagana Raghunatan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sarvaitam Sarvadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Visakam Vitamscha हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कंत राधा कंत नमोस्तुते तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिंधुभ्य एव च Patitanam pavarebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivas Adi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Yan nibadho bimanoyam tadvadhat praninam badha tatana yasya kaivalyad abhimanukilatmana parashyadamakartorhi himsa kinasya kalpyate.
So the Supreme Lord's quality is being discussed in this verse, explaining the difference between his form, which is transcendental, and ours, which is material. The Supreme Lord's body being transcendental, he is not in this, what you call, bodily concept of life. He cannot be under the modes of material nature, unlike the conditioned souls who are in the material world. Their tendency most of the times to be under the modes of material nature and under the bodily concept of life, always thinking in regards to I and mine. So therefore, according to the verse, it is incorrect to think that Krishna feels pleasure or pain when blasphemed or offered prayers, because for him, He does not identify with his body, unlike the conditioned souls like us, who tend to identify with the body as the self. We measure things according to how we are being praised or we're being blasphemed or criticized. Of course, we always wanted to be praised. We wanted always to be glorified because we think that is worthy of being glorified or being praised. But if we heard some insults against us or some criticizing from others towards us, then we feel bad or we feel hurt because we identify with the body as the self, even though we are beyond this material form. We are spirit souls. Unlike Krishna, when he is being blasphemed by the demons, for him, he doesn't feel hurt. Or when he is being offered, as we've heard from here, he's not affected even by prayers of the devotees. He doesn't want to say, "Oh, I'm being glorified, I feel good." He doesn't say like that. "Oh, I was blasphemed by this demon. That is bad. I don't like this." He's unaffected. If demons or non-devotees criticize the Supreme Lord or blaspheme the Supreme Lord, they get punished. Even though it doesn't affect Krishna, but that is the result of their actions. They've been punished by the laws of nature. If the devotees praise the Supreme Lord by choice words, praising Him, glorifying Him with very beautiful prayers, it doesn't affect Krishna as well. But it is in the favor of the devotees when they praise or chant the holy names of the Lord. They get the benefit. Either or, both for the good of either the non-devotee who is blaspheming Lord Krishna or to the devotees who are praising Lord Krishna. If they blaspheme the demons, non-devotees blaspheme or criticize Lord Krishna, they get punished. And this punishment is a form of mercy. This is for their purification. Punishment is also for purification. We are in the material world, that means we are all being punished. And Prabhupada says we're all criminals. That's why we are here in this material world. And criminals, usually they go to jail because they disobey the laws of God. And in the jail, some, they have golden chain attached to their legs. Because, you know, big criminals, they have to be chained so that they cannot run away. So some, and it says also that this material world is considered as a jail, prison house. You cannot get out of here. It's been under the surveillance of Durga Devi. You have to prove to yourself, to her, that you are a devotee. And some, due to also good karma, but still they are in jail. They have a golden chain in their legs. Some have silver chain in their legs, and some they have iron chain in their legs, the balls. You cannot run away. You've seen that in movies? We've seen that also. We don't watch movies, but we've seen that previously. So we're like that. Accordingly, we are being punished. But this punishment actually is mercy for our purification. In the scriptures as well, it says that one should not just blaspheme the Supreme Lord. One should not criticize or blaspheme a devotee, because this is detrimental for one's spiritual life. Criticizing a Vaishnava is equal to criticizing the Supreme Personality of Godhead, because the Supreme Lord is the one who feels the pain. But sometimes for Leela, devotees, they would criticize or blaspheme or even pretend themselves to be non-devotees to get the attention of the Supreme Lord and get the favor of the Supreme Lord. It's like Advaita Acharya, he's the one who is responsible for having Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared 500 years ago. And he, in order to get the attention of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and at the same time also to make sure that his position as a servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be established. Because in status-wise, Advaita Acharya is godbrother of his Guru Maharaj, Ishwarapuri. So in position, Advaita Acharya is senior or superior. But Advaita Acharya, he knew the position of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, so he doesn't want this to happen. So he pretended to be a Mayavadi. He pretended to be a non-devotee. He says that God doesn't have a form, that everyone can become God after liberation. When you leave your body, you become God as well. And everything is God. Everyone is God. They just don't realize it. So this news came to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and somebody told Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that Advaita is propagating this philosophy that everyone is God and you can also become God. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very angry. What is this? This cannot be. It's not possible. Advaita preaching this kind of philosophy. So he went to see Advaita Acharya, and at that time Advaita Acharya was giving a class, and he was saying this: yes, there is no God. The form of God is material. This deity form is not real. Everyone is God. We all can become God also after some time. When we attain liberation, you will become God and I also become God. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was, this is a big blasphemy for the Supreme Lord to hear something like this. So he came running forward to Advaita Acharya. He slapped him a few times. Say, what are you doing? This is not proper. And actually, Advaita Acharya was so happy being chastised, being slapped, being punished. Because punishment actually is a show of mercy and love to the devotees or even to the non-devotees. When the spiritual master chastises a disciple, this is the show of love of the spiritual master to the disciple to correct him for the right direction of devotional service. For neophytes, though, if we get chastised, we retaliate. We says, no, I didn't do anything wrong. you are wrong, I am right. Neophytes are like this. They don't want to be chastised. Or who wants to be chastised anyway? But, like here, Advaita Acharya, he felt good. Actually, he wanted to be chastised so that his position as the servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be established. I remember one time, my Guru Maharaj told me a very simple instruction. He told me to call somebody. Is it not that easy to make a phone call? Especially nowadays, you know, that was like many years ago. Very few have cell phones at that time. So he told me, make a phone call to this person. And then I thought, well, this is easy. I will do it later. I will do it after some time. And then he called me. Did you make a phone call? Uh-oh. My heart was beating so heavily, so fast, because I didn't follow what he told me. And I thought it was so easy. And I told him, I'm sorry, Guru Maharaj, I forgot. I did not call that person. And he chastised me so heavily. I was like almost breaking down. For such a small instruction. And I felt pain. I thought myself, well, I'm really useless. And I did not understand at that time that actually that chastisement will be for my own benefit. It's like when we were kids, when we were young, our father or our mother would chastise us or punish us, and we'll become rebellious. Instead of continue to follow their orders or instructions, we will say, if they say yes, we will say no. And if they say no, we will say yes. That's when we were young. You have that experience also? And then later on, we understood that actually this correction or chastisement or punishment that they did for us is for our own betterment. So Krishna is like this. When he punished a demon, he'll take birth in lower species of life, and then he'll understand later on, especially when he meets a devotee of the Supreme Lord. It is not so easy. It's not so easy to understand this philosophy of this chastisement or punishment from the Supreme Lord towards the rebellious conditioned soul is for their betterment. We look at it in a different angle. We look at it in a different point of view. And Lord Krishna, as it explains here, when we offer prayers to him, he does not get affected as well. He has unlimited servants. What is our prayers going to increase his ananda? Is it going to increase his happiness by our one prayer? He's unlimited. Prabhupada says in one of the lectures, even if we don't serve Krishna, Krishna will not feel empty without our service. He will not feel diminished. His ananda. Why we serve the Supreme Lord is not for his benefit. What is our service can contribute to increase his greatness? It will not. It is for our own benefit. It is for our own benefit. When we chant the holy names of the Lord, we get purified. And the more we get purified, then the more we'll have that opportunity and privilege to serve Krishna one day face to face. Unless we don't get purified, we cannot serve the purest of the pure. So, as one time, some of his disciples asked Srila Prabhupada, did you ever get chastised by your Guru Maharaj? It's a good question. And Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, one time actually he was giving a class. Prabhupada says, yes, I remember one time I was chastised by my Guru Maharaj. Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur was giving a class, and one of his god brothers, Srila Prabhupada's god brothers, was trying to say something to him. And Prabhupada, kind of like, yes, they started a little bit of a conversation. And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, he stopped. He says, you! And Prabhupada was thinking that you means him. Actually, Bhaktisiddhanta was pointing to his god brother. Says, you, what are you talking about? If you have something better to say, you come and sit here. He got chastised also, because he felt that he got chastised in that way. One time also, one of Srila Prabhupada's disciples, he wanted to get reinitiated by one of his god brothers. And he asked the blessings from Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada, can I have your blessings to get reinitiated by one of your god brothers? And Prabhupada says, yes, I bless you, you go to hell. That blessings actually is real. That in a curse, blessings also in disguise, because that will purify the disciple. Eventually, later on, he'll understand that his position, fallen position, asking Srila Prabhupada something which is against the scriptures. So chastisement means correction. This correction is very important. It's like Kaliya. Kaliya, we've heard that story, chapter 16 of the Krishna book, where Lord Krishna danced on the hood of Kaliya. Now a snake by nature is envious. Even without provocation, and there's a snake there, and you move in a wrong way, suddenly the snake will bite you. Because thinking that, hey, you're in my territory. What are you doing in my territory? You're not supposed to be here. I am the king here. Envious mentality. So Lord Krishna, somehow, the Nagapatnis are the wives of Kaliya. They're also having a form of snakes. And they cannot figure out what is the mercy that our husband attained. What kind of pious activities that he performed in the past that somehow Lord Krishna's lotus feet touch his body. Because Lord Krishna's lotus feet is the goal of all the yogis, is the goal of all the devotees to take shelter under his lotus feet. It's like we have deities here. We touch feet of the Supreme Lord or those who are spiritually advanced. We want to touch their feet. And it's very rare to touch The lotus feet of the Supreme Lord. Very rare. Even Lakshmi Devi. Even Lakshmi Devi, she is so fortunate also. Massaging. Only massaging. But not having that lotus feet touch the head of Lakshmi Devi. What kind of pious activities that our husband performed in the past? I'm just going to read part of that prayer of the Nagapatnis to understand this. The Nagapatnis began to offer their prayers as follows. O dear Lord, you are equal to everyone. It's like the title of this. The Lord is equal to everyone. Title of this chapter. For you, there is no distinction between your sons, friends, or enemies. Again, there's no distinction between demons or devotees or sons or enemies. Therefore, the punishment which you have so kindly offered to Kaliya is exactly befitting. O Lord, you have descended specially for the purpose of annihilating all kinds of disturbing elements within the world. And because you are the absolute truth, there is no difference between your mercy and punishment. Again, it's the same. It's like in the purport, as Srila Prabhupada mentions. We think, therefore, that this apparent punishment to Kaliya is actually some benediction. We consider that your punishment is your great mercy upon us, because when you punish someone, it is to be understood that the reaction of his sinful activities are eradicated. It is already clear that this creature appearing in the body of a serpent must have been overburdened with all kinds of sin. Otherwise, how could he have the body of a serpent? Your dancing on his hoods reduces all the sinful results of actions caused by his having this body of a serpent. It is therefore very auspicious that you have become angry and have punished him in this way. We are very astonished to see how you have become so pleased with this servant who evidently performed various religious activities in his past lives. Everyone must have been pleased by his undergoing all kinds of penances and austerities, and he must have executed universal welfare activities for all living creatures. Anything that's been done by a devotee for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord will never be forgotten by the Supreme Lord himself. When it comes the right time, the Supreme Lord will reciprocate accordingly. Nalakubar and Manigriva as well. They were cursed by Narad Muni to be trees, Arjun trees, twin Arjun trees, for thousands of years because of their intoxicating mentality. They were so intoxicated about their wealth being the sons of Kuvera, the treasurer of the demigods, that they did not even recognize when Narad Muni was passing by. They were intoxicated with so much pride and false ego that they did not even cover their bodies when Narad Muni was passing by. So they were cursed to be twin Arjun trees. But then that curse actually is a benediction at the same time, because that will have the opportunity for them to have darshan of Lord Krishna 5,000 years ago in his Balya Lila, childhood pastimes. For many, they have to perform thousands of years of austerities and penances to attain darshan of the Supreme Lord. But that kind of fault of Nalakuvar and Manigriva, they didn't have to perform thousands of austerities to have darshan of the Supreme Lord. Narad Muni, being a sadhu, his curse is also a benediction at the same time. But for us, we don't want to be like demons to get the mercy of the Supreme Lord immediately. As Prabhupada mentions in the purport, Krishna punishes a demon or conditioned soul. He stops the soul's habit of blaspheming him, and when the soul becomes completely pure, the Lord takes him back home, back to Godhead. We don't have to go into that route, to that way or direction whereby, oh, let me become a demon and then Krishna will chastise me, and then in this way it'll be easier for me to have darshan of the Supreme Lord. That may take many, many millions of lifetimes before we reach to that far. However, even though whatever background we came from, doesn't matter how much sinful activities we have performed in the past, just by uttering the holy names of the Lord, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Instantly, if we do chant the holy names of the Lord purely, sincerely, then will be able to attain the mercy of the Supreme Lord, which is very difficult to attain in previous yugas. In this day and age, everyone is qualified to chant the holy name of the Lord. It's not because one is rich, he can chant the holy name of the Lord, and you are poor, you cannot chant the holy name of the Lord. It is not that because you're a woman, you cannot chant the holy name of the Lord, and you're a man, you can chant the holy name of the Lord. It's not that because one is very intelligent, you can chant the holy name of the Lord, and you are not so intelligent, you cannot chant the holy name of the Lord. It's not because it's young, you can chant, and others who are old, you cannot chant. Everybody is eligible to chant the holy name of the Lord. What Krishna is looking for us is our sincerity. Sincerity means being focused. Sincerity means without any ulterior motive. Just dedication in this process. And then we will attain the mercy of the Supreme Lord. Hopefully, one day in this lifetime. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Any questions? Any other questions? Oh, yes.
Hare Krishna. So, giving the punishment and chastising, actually, Radhani also does not lie. One time, this is not my question.
Hold on. Is this a comment or a question?
Comment. Because Radhani also does not lie, giving the punishment and chastising. So, therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come. Not giving any kind of punishment and chastising,
he
will give Krishna
Prema.
Would I any kind of chastising and punishment?
So no, hold on. I think it's wrong what you said. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is ready to punish Jagai and Madai, isn't it? He's ready to cut their heads with a chakra. So you're wrong. It's Lord Nityananda. Lord Nityananda is the one who never gets angry. Okay? You don't accept what I said? We will talk later. But try to accept what I said. Lord Chaitanya is ready to kill Jagai and Madai because Jagai and Madai hurt and blasphemed Lord Nityananda. But your statement was the other way around. You don't accept this? I'm sorry. But Lord Nityananda, no. He asked Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, don't get angry because your purpose of coming will be defeated. So it was Lord Nityananda. Correct, Adipurush Prabhu? Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Jai Nitai.